Hi class 5, welcome back to the maths class once again. So today we are going to continue the geometrical constructions. Okay, now for the geometrical construction, what we need a protector, a sharp pencil, an eraser, a compass with another pencil attached, both differently. Okay, and one ruler as usual. Now we are going to start the construction. Okay, now for drawing three type of triangles we are going to learn, and for that we need three sizes. Okay, for that I have already taken first one, that is 5 cm, next one is 7.5 cm, another one is 6 cm. Okay, now the first one is equilateral triangle. Now for equilateral triangle, we have already known that the side of the triangle should be equal. Okay, so for that reason, what we are going to take? We are going to take 5 cm size for all of its size. Okay, so we are going to take one size, and that is 5 cm. Okay, so here for what we are going to do first, we are going to take the compass, and then we are going to take the size of 5 cm. Alright, so here be very concise about taking the size. So here we are going to put the compass out here and then just measure the size. Alright, then I'm keeping this ahead. Now by using the ruler pencil, I'm going to take a size arbitrarily. Okay, so straight line, I'm going to draw one arbitrarily. I don't know the size of it. Alright. Now, as we have already taken the size, that is 5 cm from here. So, I am going to take a mark, that is 5 cm from here. So, I am going to put the sharp end of the compass in one end of the line and then draw a incision. Okay. So, be very precise about this, and I'm going to name it. Okay, so here A and B. Alright, so one side is already done. Now the time for other two sides for the triangle. For that I'm going to put the sharp end of the compass out here in the point B. Okay, then from here I'm going to take a incision out there in the top. Okay, and then once again I'm going to put this sharp end at the point A, then take another incision, and for during that we are not going to change the size, that is 5 cm that we have taken from here. Okay, so ultimately the incision what we have already taken by placing the compass out here, those are 5 cm. Now what we are going to do, we are going to put a point and name it C. Okay, now we are going to use the scale and then join the point B and C. Okay, like this. Another one from here, A and C. Alright, and this is how we make a triangle. Triangle A B C is equals to an equilateral triangle. Alright, where A B B B C and A C, three are the sides of it. Alright, and all of its angle will be equal. Now after that, coming to the next one, that is isosceles triangle. Now we know the property of the isosceles triangle, that means both of the side of the triangle will be of equal size and one side will be different. Alright, now for that we are going to use two sizes. Okay, now here look at this, the sizes we have already taken, that is 5 cm and 7.5 cm. Alright, now we are going to use two sizes, 5 cm and 7.5 cm. And we are going to take the base, that is 5 cm, here. Alright, now let's take the base and we are going to draw a straight line arbitrarily once again. Alright, now 5 cm we have already taken before only. So I'm going to take the size from here by taking another incision and name it A, B. Alright, now after that what we are going to do, we are going to take the size of 7.5 cm. That it means from here. Alright, so we have taken the sizes 7.5 cm. So I'm going to put the needle once again in the point B and take an incision at the top. And from A, I'm going to take another incision just over the previous incision. Okay, and then take a point out here and then name it. Let's say that is C. After that, what we are going to do? We know all that we are going to join the points BC and AC. Okay. Now, in this triangle, what has been seen that this size, that is side AB, is 5 cm, while sides BC and AC are 7.5 cm and 7.5 cm. Okay, that's why triangle ABC is equals to an isosceles triangle. Now, after the isosceles triangle, we are going to start with scalene triangle. Okay, so here, now for scalene triangle, we know the property of a scalene triangle, that is the side of the triangle will be unequal, that means no side of it will be equal to each other. For that reason, while constructing, I have taken already three different sizes. One is 4 cm, 6 cm and 7 cm. Alright, now we are going to draw it. Now for the base of the triangle, I am going to take the largest one, that is 7 cm. Okay, so here, let's draw an arbitrary line once again. Alright, so here I have taken the line. Now I am going to take the measure of the 7 cm from here. So we can see that I have taken the 7 cm. Now I am going to put the sharp end of the compass in one edge of the straight line and then take the incision for 7 cm. And hence we have taken the incision, that is in 7 cm. Let's give it a name of A and B. Now after that, we need two sides, both of different sizes. For that, I am taking another size, that is 6 cm. So here, the 6 cm, I am going to put the sharp edge at point A and take the 6 cm incision here. Alright, after that, let's take it a big bit because the other size will be the smaller one. So here, 4 cm, the last one is 4 cm. Therefore, I'm going to put the sharp edge at point B and take another incision, the shorter one, that is of 4 cm. So we can see that here, the point from point B, I have taken the 4 cm incision. So I'm naming it O. Okay. Now let's join it. I'm joining the point A and O first. So here A and O, I'm joining it. After that, the point O and B. So in this way, we make a scalene triangle where all of its sides are different. Here that is 4 cm, this is 7 cm. And side AO is 6 cm. and the triangle ABO is equals to scalene. All right. Now after that, we are going to learn another thing, that is, when we are using two sides and one angle, how we are going to draw another construction. Okay, so for two sides, I am taking two of the sides, that is 4 centimeter and 6 centimeter. Okay, and for the angle, I am using 45 degree. All right, so for that, the first straight line I have taken, one straight line, then I am measuring the biggest one, that is 6 centimeter of two sides. So here it's 6 centimeter, so I'm taking the incision of 6 centimeter from here. All right, so here I'm going to once again name it A and B and put the size 6 centimeter. After that, what we are going to do, we are going to use the protractor. All right, why? Because we have to take an angle that is 45 degree. Now I have already told you and showed you how we take the angles, or how we measure the angles. We align this straight line or the bezel line with the bezel line of the construction. So here I'm going to coincide both of it and see where the 45 degree angle is going to fall upon. So here between 40 and 50, you can see here 45 degree, the middle line is 45 degree. So I'm going to put the point out here. Okay. After that, what we are going to do, we are going to take a join or take a long straight line from here. All right. Then I'm going to measure the 4 centimeter, another line, that is another size that is given. All right. So from here, I'm taking an incision at 4 centimeter. Alright. So here, 6 centimeter done, 4 centimeter done. So nothing is more given. So we can take, we can join. I'm going to name it what? O. Alright. So here I'm joining the point O and point B for making or completing the triangle. So this is how we make a triangle, that is triangle AOB out here, by using a scale, protractor, compass and pencil obviously, and when the two sides are given and one angle is given. Okay, now for the last one, that is when we need to find the triangle by using two angles and one side. Now for that, let's say one side is taken as 6 centimeter. All right, so here once again we are going to take a arbitrary straight line first and then measure the 6 centimeter, measure the 6 centimeter from the size I have already taken, or you are also going to take like this for your own convenience, and then we are going to take the incision at 6 centimeter. Now at the 6 centimeter, we are going to name it and put the size at the substratum. Then what we are going to do, we are going to use the protractor, protractor for marking the angles. Okay, for the first one, I am going to mark the 45 degree angle from point A. All right, so here from A, where is the 45 degree angle is lying? Here, just between 40 and 50 degree. So from there, we are going to take a straight line from point A. Just the point, the straight line should cross from the point taken. Then from again from point B, take the 30 degree. Now 30 degree, where we are going to find the 30 degree out here. At this point, so here we are going to find the 30 degree. All right, so just join the point where we have taken the 30 degree and from the point B. So take the incision from there and draw a straight line just over it and let two of the straight line cross each other, intersect each other. Okay, and then we are done. Here, the point of intersection is going to be named, and here we are going to name the triangle as AOB, and we are going to measure what are the sizes of the sides, where AO, firstly we know the size of AB, so here AB equals to 6 centimeter, while we are going to measure the AO and BO. So let's measure the size of AO, that is 3 centimeter, and for the BO, that is almost 5 centimeter. Alright, so this is how we draw this type of triangle by using two angles, when two angles are given and one side is given. Okay, so this is it for this class. I hope you have understand how to perform the construction by using two sides and one angle, two angles and one side at once. Then other than that, the three type of triangles. So this is it for this class, and we are going to see each other in our next video. Till then, keep practicing, and thank you for watching.